The stories of alien beings or gods visiting the Earth has been around for thousands of years. It is by no stretch of the imagination a new phenomenon. From gods descending to the Earth and blasting off in chariots, to fallen angels and even millions of cases of abductions, the truth is suppressed on a scale of magnitudes that is so hard to comprehend, most of us turn the other cheek. The answers are startlingly obvious when closely observed. The strange thing regarding these situations and stories as described in ancient literature is that they compare to modern experiences such as alien abduction stories, and they seem to be identical. The stories and legends have been around for centuries. They can't all just be made up, can they? We think not. They're too prolific and too widespread across the globe. There simply has to be more truth to them. For what purpose have these things been happening throughout history? And why is the alien beings responsible, not making their presence more public? Is it well hushed up by world leaders, but the stories are circulated throughout the world? This is not mass hysteria, it's actual fact. Are these visitors simply being cautious? Are we even ready for this type of disclosure, or are we still centuries away from acceptance in this regard? Perhaps the most important thing that runs through the abduction stories is that all the people that are returned, they're not kept. But why? What we refer to today as alien abduction can be traced back thousands of years. Are those that are returned part of a bigger extraterrestrial plan? Perhaps more evidence can be found by examining an ancient abduction that took place in the jungles of Southeast Asia hundreds of years ago. Wait till you hear this one, guys. A group of missionaries traveling through the Cambodian jungle stumbled across the largest and most elaborate religious complex ever built in the world. It's called Angkor Wat. The people there mysteriously abandoned the ancient site around the 15th century. It became engulfed by the surrounding jungle vegetation and lay forgotten about for hundreds of years. Cambodian lore credits its design to a half-human, half-divine architect who is said to have been taken off-planet and returned to Earth with the plans to build this massive advanced complex. The legend is one of the best stories you could ever imagine for the ancient alien hypothesis. In the legend, he is taken to what's called the Andhra Heaven, which was orbiting the Earth as described in the ancient Vedic text. When the abductee was first taken to go to Andhra's Heaven, he was exposed to a blue light where he described how he felt his entire body being rejuvenated. Could it be that this was some type of energizing pod for both body and mind? It's quite amazing that an ancient Cambodian legend like this would contain a scene where the main character has to go through some sort of process that's done in space. It's done in the celestial home of the gods. He underwent an intense education program, and weeks later he was rejoining his people, where he essentially imparted all this knowledge that was given to him by the heavenly beings to his people. Upon his return, he's said to have designed Angkor Wat. It was built as a replica of the heavenly city he visited in anticipation of the return of the alien gods. We can look back in countless religious texts where contactees are given rules and regulations and ideas to follow in terms of elevating and advancing the human race. And sometimes they would build structures or carry out tasks for the gods wherever that might be. It could well be an ongoing program that hasn't stopped since the dawn of time, and in that respect, the alien gods are experts in their trade. We humans just don't realize what's going on. Is it possible that this story is true? Are select humans being taken off-planet and inserted back into society even today? And to what end? Perhaps more clues can be found by exploring the details of modern alien abductions. The most popular of these abduction cases is that of Barney and Betty Hill. The couple encountered a UFO incident while driving home from a holiday in 1961. A large disc-shaped craft hovered over their car directly in the middle of a deserted highway road where they felt compelled to stop and get out of the car. Barney Hill claimed to see 11 humanoid figures within the craft through binoculars. A telepathic voice instructed him, "Stop and stay calm." But he soon felt that they were going to be captured, so he floored it. The Hills entered an altered state of consciousness, and upon their reawakening, they found that they had driven 35 miles south with only vague memories of what took place. When they arrived home, they both began to experience strange sensations and impulses. Their watches stopped working permanently. Barney's dress shoes were scraped, his binocular case ripped, and Betty's dress was torn. They both drew pictures of what they could remember. The drawings are remarkably similar. The Hills reported their experience to the U.S. Air Force and were eventually by a UFO research group who confirmed that the Hills were telling the truth. Both Betty and Barney were placed under hypnosis in 1964, which revealed far greater details as to what actually took place. Not long after driving off in a panic, Barney recalled feeling irresistibly compelled to suddenly pull off the road and drive into the woods. After stopping, they were approached by six figures who were between 4 and 5 feet tall and wearing uniforms. The leader instructed Barney not to fear them and to close his eyes. Both Barney and Betty each reported being taken on board the craft by these beings who communicated telepathically. Sperm was taken from Barney and other tests performed on Betty. The Hill story is possibly the most documented UFO abduction case in history and has been studied by many researchers and experts throughout the world who all remain completely baffled and reached the same conclusion that this is a genuine case of aliens abducting humans. Does this account not blow your mind to pieces? We may not have the answers, guys, but now at least we do have the question. What do you think? Comments below. Thanks for watching.